I wanted to talk a moment about what I just found out and discovered with regards to my son. I'm grateful to him for being the only person that's been honest to me in this situation so far. He's the person that's been the most honest to me with regards to the situation surrounding my daughter, Tiara. I'm very upset because I just had to find out from my son that he feels very much like he was being manipulated into not saying anything about where my daughter was so that he could continue to have a relationship with her. That's blackmail and extortion and a whole bunch of other things, especially when it's been eating away at him that he knew that he wasn't related to these people and that they lied about it, not just in court, but to everybody else as well. And they've been putting on a big facade this whole time, trying to make me look like I was crazy and all this and that, because I care about my daughter and I want her to come home. And they were trying to make me look like I was mentally ill and taking advantage of the situation, manipulating. They taught my daughter to lie and manipulate. She's 7 years old. And they had her lying and manipulating to the point where she felt she had to hide from me in shame. This is the type of people that my daughter was appointed to take care of her. These are people that claim to be pastors and Christians and people that claim to be of good standing citizens in their community. And this is what they've done in response to me standing up for myself as a victim and for my daughter. They taught her how to hurt me, and these people thought it was funny to continue to do that to me and my child after everything we've already been through. Excuse me, I'm very upset, especially with the system right now, because the system promoted this, and they thought it was funny. For these people to be allowed to lie knowingly to the court about being related to us, and I've got the documents to verify that they're not, I want them criminally charged for what they've done. What they did was fraud on the court. It's extortion. They put both of my children in the middle of it and had them lying to me and manipulating me so that they could see each other still. These are people that are supposed to be role models. They awarded my daughter, custody of my daughter to these people that are doing this and have continued to do this for a very long time. At least for 6 to 8 months, if not longer. My son's afraid to tell me how long they've had my daughter because he doesn't want them to cut off communication between the two of them. And so we've got a situation here, and they're mad because I keep enforcing it that we're not related to them and that they lied to the court. And I just can't trust or respect them for that. Because they also expressed to my son that they knew that they were lying about being related to the court when they did it. They promised to return my daughter and haven't done that. They haven't kept their word on anything that they've done. And so I'm sitting here looking at these people going, are you kidding me? These are the type of people that they placed my daughter with. And this isn't a lie. It's the truth. I talked to Mr. Rose from Department of Health and Human Services the day before Thanksgiving, and he didn't know that's what the situation was. And I'm going to tell you that considering the situation, again, I want charges pressed on these people. It's not just the fact that they lied to the judge about being related to me, because that's the only reason they were placed with the, they had my daughter placed with them, because they live in Missouri and we live in Michigan. They're like some 1,200 miles away from us. They had to have intent to come out here from Missouri with fake documents to lie about being related to us and tell the judge that. And I don't know what else was said, but my son said he was really upset because they kept trying to lie and say I was mentally ill when I'm not. There's not one single therapist or psychiatrist that said that. Not a single one of them. Not in my presence. All of them said, give Tiara back to me. Every therapist that testified that I saw. And my son's telling me, well, Mom, you just don't know, because they said one thing in front of you and a whole nother thing behind your back. And so this is the situation. And the fact that it was provoked because I reported abuse, not just of people, but of the system, is appalling. And I'm sitting here going, these people literally turned my kids against me. And they had my kids hiding where my daughter was because they were afraid to be honest. That's not a reflection of me. That's a reflection of the people that have my daughter. And they should go to jail for that, because that's a form of abuse. It's also persecution that they manipulated both of my children into lying to everybody about the situation and being put in the middle, because they wanted to retaliate, because Emily got blasted out for being disrespectful to her elders and refuses to take responsibility. So her and Robbie caused all of this mess. It was already bad enough we were in court because I've reported abuse. But rather than have my back and stand up for me, they lied and manipulated the court into giving Tiara to them, my youngest daughter, so that they could use her to torture and exploit me and my son, which is really horrific. And again, they need to go to jail for it. If I had done it, they would have put me in jail for that type of behavior, which is exactly why they need to go to jail for it, especially considering they came out here from Missouri, and which is makes it a federal issue, really, because it's across state lines. They came out here from Missouri in order to lie to the judge, knowing they were lying to the judge. I have a problem with that, and so should every judge, lawyer, district attorney, and other court and law official in our country. That's the exact type of stuff that causes animosity with the people towards the court, and we need to do something to make it stop. Again, I'm pursuing charges against Robert and Emily Dole because they're of no relation to us. My documents are in order. With God's love. God bless America. Have a blessed day. And back the badge.